Hello and welcome to Dollar Country. I'm Frank the Drifter and this is Zane Martin and Bobby Shepherd.
Stop accusing me.
Good enough for me. Take this hammer, carry it to the captain. Take this hammer, carry it to the captain. Take this hammer, carry it to the captain. Tell him I'm gone, tell him I'm gone. If he asks you, was I running? If he asks you, was I running?
Day.
Howdy, folks, and welcome to Dollar Country, episode 224. Dollar Country is, of course, the show where I share country 45s forgotten along the path of history, sometimes never were known in the first place to be forgotten about, all the whiffs, strikeouts, and beanballs from the golden age of country music. I'm your host, Frank the Drifter, and start off the show today with Zane Martin and Bobby Shepherd. Song was Stop Accusing Me on Bright Records, that's B-R-Y-T-E, from 1964. Bright Records at this point was located in Newbury, Ohio. However, later they were located in Nashville. Or Bright Records was in Ohio, but then Bright Star, B-R-I-T-E, and Bright, B-R-Y-T-E, without the records, was located in different places. A lot of these record labels went through a lot of name changes, and who knows, it was just, you know, sloppiness or, or you know, legal stuff. But yeah, it started off in Ohio, then moved to Nashville later on, and was pretty interesting stuff. Everything I found on Bright, the B-R-Y-T-E, has been pretty good, pretty interesting. I do run into them occasionally. Hamilton isn't so far from here. It was run by Tex Clark, who by most accounts was kind of a hustler who could not be trusted. Also very common in the old school record world. Actually, I think it's common now in the record world as well. After that was Lowell Varney with My Daddy Was a Preacher on REM Records from 1965. That is Lowell Varney. I played on the show a few episodes ago, in the last like 10 or 12, and he was a bluegrass banjo player from Crum, West Virginia, C-R-U-M, and later on, I believe he was based out of Nashville as well. We had Rudy Thacker and his String Busters, and The String Busters, vocal by Larry Huff, with Take This Hammer on Mark Records, that's Mark, M-A-A-R-C, and it's out of Canton, Ohio, which is also up near me. Canton is kind of down by Akron. 1965 on that one. After that, we had Candy Noe, N-O-E, the last name there, with Buck Up, Back Out on Galena Records from 1966. I couldn't find an exact citation, but I'm pretty sure that Candy and this label were both out of the Tulsa, Oklahoma City area. There's other stuff on Galena from that area, and but I couldn't find anything about Candy herself for whatever reason. Behind us today is Amos Chase and his old time fiddle. I love fiddle records. So back in the day, I was listening to some fiddle records today. I listen to records when I'm doing stuff. And one interesting thing about fiddle records is that there used to be old-time fiddle contests everywhere. Like, even, like, as small as at the county level. Like, towns, counties, states, national. They'd all have these different, fiddle competitions. And also, like, banjo competitions and old-time music competitions. But for whatever reason, fiddle seemed to be the one that made the most records. And I swear, if you placed in a fiddle competition, no matter how small, you could put out a fiddle record and say, Championship Fiddler. And nobody really looked into it. Nobody was like, oh, this guy was like third place in the, you know, Carson County Fiddle Competition, which has a population of like 2,000 people. It doesn't matter. You still were technically a winner, you know? And I really like that about fiddle things. All the fiddle records kind of sound very similar because it's all fiddle tunes and there's not that many fiddle tunes. But I really enjoy the enthusiasm that fiddle players have to release a record after they've placed in some sort of fiddle competition. But anyway, I should probably do a fiddle show sometime. That'd be kind of fun. I forgot how I started talking about that. But anyway, before I jump back in, I would like to remind you that Dollar Country is supported by your donations. If you would like to support the show, you can find out more information at patreon.com. That's patreon.com/dollarcountry. If you want to follow me on social medias, you can do so. It is at Dollar Country on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, and Threads. Although Twitter and Threads are It's a changing social media landscape, I'll put it that way. Who knows what's going to happen? But you can definitely find me on Instagram at Dollar Country. Dollarcountry.org is the website and database where you can look at all the records I play on the show. I just uploaded all the stuff from episodes 220, 221, 222, and 223. So you can go there and click around and find all the information, all that stuff. You can also sign up for the email list at dollarcountry.org if you want to get an email whenever a new episode is out. And the phone number is 216-505-4071 if you would like to call and leave a message or a request. The number is 216-505-4071. And jumping back in, this is going to be something out of Georgia, Atlanta, Georgia, with the William Brothers with The Last Time.
Just kissed her sweet lips for the last time. Just held her in my arms the last time. I just said hello to loneliness. Just said I love you the last time. I still can't make my heart believe that we're really through. There's nothing left but false emotion. What else can I do? Loving you was just a big mistake. So I'll just walk away the last time. Still can't make my heart believe that we're really through. There's nothing left but false emotion. What else can I do? Loving you was just a big mistake. So I'll just walk away the last time. And he hardly saw me come.
hands were wrinkled, his hair was gray, his eyes no longer young. I turned and asked, I watched him pass. Tears, they filled my eyes. I knew I'd been looking at the past, and the face I saw was mine.
Walked in. I live alone in till she returns to me. Yes, I guess I'll go on living with the blues. Living with the blues. Living with the blues. Yes, I guess I'll go on living with the blues.
My watch as it ticks away the time, looking at a picture of a girl that once was mine. No time is not on my side anymore. I just got to find a true girl. I'm just a warm-hearted man living in a cold-hearted must have been through 100 or more. Never found one I could trust. And out of them all, that has told me a lie. We couldn't haul them in a bus. No time is not on my side anymore. I've just got to find a true girl. I'm just a warm-hearted man living in a cold. I've been through 100 or more, and never found one I could trust. And out of them all, that has told me a lie. We couldn't haul them in a bus. No time is not on my side anymore. I've just got to find a true girl. I'm just a warm-hearted man living in a cold.
Down in my chair, I thought that I'd take a rest. But suddenly, with impish glee, she was standing there, my sweet little dirty faced angel. There was dirt streaked on her face from the active childish play, and the sparkle in her pretty eyes brought completeness to my day, brushed the tiredness far away.
All right, folks, welcome back to Dollar Country, episode 224. And I started off that set with William Bros, the William Brothers, the William Bros. It says William Bros on the thing. Jimmy and Bobby Williams, The Last Time was the name of that tune. That was out of Northeast Atlanta, at Atlanta, Georgia. And that was from 1963. After that, we had Dick Ryan with Reflections of a Man on DJ Records from 1969. That one is actually from Cleveland, Ohio, where I am currently sitting. And then we had the Roan Brothers with My Brother Sleeps in Vietnam on Wedge Records from 1966. Wedge has a really cool label. It has like a log with a wedge in it, as if you were chopping it. Another person on Wedge Records was Stella Parton, Dolly Parton's sister, who did have a country career, although I don't blame you if you never heard of her. She was not nearly as popular. But yeah, Wedge Records, just one of those labels that's so cool looking. I always pick it up, even though a lot of them are not really that great. Also like that song started off with like a Peter Frampton style talk box voice almost. I don't know where that technology came from in 1966. I know Pete Drake was doing a talking style thing then. Maybe he was on that track, who knows. Then Luke Majors with Living with the Blues on Lash Records. I do not have a year on that one. Luke Majors was based out of North Carolina, and he played with the Carolina Playboys, was his band from North Carolina. Burlington, North Carolina. Then we had Jimmy Watford with Cold Hearted Woman on Red Carpet Records. Jimmy Watford and his wife, who was the songwriter, Barbara Joyce Watford, were located mostly in Alabama and Georgia. I believe they were both born in Alabama. I know I found her obituary. She passed away in Alabama, but it also said they lived in Georgia for a bit. I don't have a year on that one either. And then lastly, we had Leanne Mack with Dirty Faced Angel on Pretty Girl Records from 1969. Pretty Girl is a label out of Memphis by Style Wooten. And one thing I like about Pretty Girl Records is that the label has a picture of the artist. So Leanne Mack is on the label here. Pretty neat. And it is the second break, which means it's time for Book Corner. Last time I was reading a book about shape note singing, and I had to put that one down because it was incredibly dry. It turned out the first part was pretty interesting. It had parts about shape note singing, history and stuff, but then eventually it just became really short, like 2 or 3 page chapters about people that the author knew. Like people she had met while doing singing, and these people were just... Basically, she just talked about them going to church and stuff, and eventually got to the point where I was dreading reading the book, and so I put it down, decided it'd be good for reference in the future, and picked up a book I've read before, but I thought I'd read again, called American Gods by Neil Gaiman. It's kind of I guess it technically would be fantasy, but it's a really interesting book. I've read it before. It's like over 700 pages, but somehow it reads like it's 300 pages. It's a really interesting style, and if you've read Neil Gaiman before, the way he writes is kind of like a childlike sense of wonder. Like, you know, remember when you were a kid and you saw something you didn't understand, so you just assumed it was magic, and you were like made up stories about how it worked, and then when you got older you realized it was like, oh, this is how it works, or like science figured that out, it's not a big deal. He has a tendency to write stories in that way, that it's almost like magic, that sort of magic still exists, and I find that really interesting and really amazing. And so the point of this book is how as long as somebody remembers a god, then that god exists. So there's gods like Odin going way back, and there's new gods. And I like that idea. And thinking about like how many cultures did like the Romans or the Vikings destroy back in the day, who had gods that now we don't remember because all these people were killed. But we remember all the Roman and Greek and Norse gods because in essence they were the winners, because they destroyed these other cultures, you know. And we'll never know. That's just the way the world works. And there's a lot of stuff in history we'll never know, because the people who cared about it passed away or were destroyed on purpose, as is sometimes the case. But anyway, this book, I'm really enjoying it. If you like that kind of stuff, maybe check it out. It's American Gods by Neil Gaiman. It's really well known. I'm sure you can find a copy at a cheap bookstore somewhere. So anyway, jump back in here. Let's see what I got. Let's see. All right. This is Benny Strong and Gene Jenkins with Ramblin' Man.
Just a lonely traveler with a heart that loves to roam. I've been all around this country. Everywhere is home. Everywhere is home. Once had me a woman, fine as she could be. She just couldn't take my rambling. She walked out on me. She walked out on me. 'Cause I'm a rambling man, singing a song, carefree and happy to keep rambling on. Just a rambling man, singing a song, carefree and happy to keep rambling on. My heart must be a hobo, the loneliness I've known, to wake up in the morning feeling so alone, feeling so alone. 'Cause I'm a rambling man, singing a song, carefree and happy to keep rambling on. Just a rambling man, singing a song, carefree and happy to keep rambling on.
sure have been around. All my journeys sometimes take me to some lonesome town, to some lonesome town. When my days are over, to lighten up the load, well, I'll let my memories take me down that lonesome road, down that lonesome road. 'Cause I'm a rambling man, singing a song, carefree and happy to keep rambling on. Just a rambling man, singing a song, carefree and happy to keep rambling on. Carefree and happy to keep rambling on.
Sanity. start each night at 5. Drink to remember with the help of warm red wine. Drink to remember how it was when she was mine. All these nights in a bar room keep my sanity alive. Yes, I drink to remember, and I start each night at 5.
Things were kind of quiet, we were looking for a thrill, so we decided that we'd try it. All we heard about the stuff, we had to see if it were true. One whole jug was sure enough, cause here would have put us through. We seen crawling critters at our feet and snakes hung off the wall. The monsters all had saber teeth and stood 15 foot tall. And something green crawled through the door and there were more out on the hill. We lay face down on the floor there in Pappy's. Feeling sick, and it weren't enough what we've been through. Here come Pappy with his stick. He tanned our hide and ruined our pride, and even broke the will. Now each time we sit, we won't forget that I'm broken Pappy's will. We seen crawling critters at our feet and snakes hung off the wall. The monsters all had saber teeth and stood 15 foot tall. And something green crawled through the door, and there were more out on the hill. We laid face down on the floor there in Pappy's Hill. Oh, we laid face down on the floor there in Pappy's Hill.
Fast gun.
Fast gun.
I rode into Dust Run, had a challenge to me. The OK saloon at the end of the street. I hated to go, but the rim that I had was wanted by all men who long to be bad.
Fast gun,
fast gun.
The doors they swung open and out in the street. The young man came walking that I was to meet. I knew by the look of fear in his eyes. He was carrying a gun much too large for his size.
Fast gun,
fast gun.
Fast gun,
fast gun.
Within 20 paces I said, boy, go back. He started to draw and then made his last track. Before he unholstered, I emptied a round. That's in the boy tumbling to the hot dusty ground.
Fast gun,
fast gun.
I knelt down beside him, lifted his head. Sickened as I listened to the few words he said. His last breath was gone, my eyes filled with tears. For I knew it was my brother I'd not seen for years.
Fast gun,
fast gun.
They came from the east, came from the west, all just to challenge the gun that was best. The one that I've worn all so long with much pride, but I wish that tomorrow, today, I'd have died.
Fast gun,
fast gun,
fast gun,
fast gun.
Thank you.
All right, folks, welcome back to the end of the show. Episode 224 today of Dollar Country, of course. And so I start off that last set with Benny Strong and Gene Jenkins with Ramblin' Man, not a cover of the more famous Ramblin' Man you probably know by Hank Williams. Or I don't think it was. No, it's just a different one altogether. I feel like usually you don't really like name a new song after a really famous other song, but these guys did it. That's on Marjan Records from, I think, 1968, but I'm not completely sure on that. Then we had Holland Wilson with Long Black Veil on Decco Records from 1964. That's out of Hudson, Ohio. Decco is related to another label called Ohio that I played on the show before. And that was Holland Wilson with the Buckeye Strings. And yeah, pretty upbeat version of Long Black Veil. I think almost every version of that I've heard has been more of like a slow ballad, so that was kind of nice. And after that, we had George Lewis with Drinks Remember on High Low Records out of Nashville, Tennessee. That is George Lewis and the Traveling Nashville Band. And that one is from 1970. We had Rich Schiller with The Night We Broke In Pappy Still on Night Records from, I think, 1976. And that label is out of Winnetka, California. Otherwise, I could not find out any information about that one. Although I liked it. I enjoyed that tune. Then lastly, we had one on Neighbor Records, N-A-B-O-R. Damon Long with the song Fast Gun. And that is from 1962. And Neighbor was out of Indianapolis, Indiana. I have one or two others on that label. They've all been pretty good. So, you know, I pick them up when I find them. And let's see, the records on this came from two people, Tom and Brandon, so thanks to those two. These records I bought back in 2022, I think, which is more than half a year ago, as we're getting solidly into 223 now, 223, or 2023, I swear. My brain is just smooth sometimes. So let's see. I do have one more for you as always. And the last one is going to be a cover of one of my favorite songs, Redneck Mother. But before we get there, I would like to remind you to be nice to people out there, because you never know what kind of day someone else has been having, and a little bit of niceness can go a long way. And once again, if you do want to support the show, it would mean so much to me, of course. But if you want to find out more information, you can go to patreon.com/dollarcountry. And all the social medias is at Dollar Country, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, Threads, Friendster, MySpace. And that's that. So this last one's going to be JJ and the Texas Stompers on Stomper Records from, I think, 1975 with Up Against the Wall, Redneck Mother. And here goes. I'll catch y'all next time. Thanks for listening. This has been Dollar Country, and I've been Frank the Drifter, so I'll talk to you next episode.
He was born in Oklahoma. His wife's name was Betty Lou Thelma Liz. He's not responsible for what he's doing, 'cause his mother made him what he is. He sure does like his long neck beard, likes to chase it with that wild turkey liquor. He's got a 57 GMC pickup truck. It's got a gun rack, and goat ropers need love to stickers. It's up against the wall, redneck mother. Mother who has raised son so and raised in hell. Oh, play one for mother. The mud flaps she gave me for my pickup truck. O is for the oil I put on my hair. T is for T-Bird. H is for Haggard. E is for eggs. And R is
redneck.
Up against the wall, redneck mother. Mother who has raised the son so well. He's 34 and drinking in a honky-tonk, just kicking hippies' asses and raising hell. Oh, and it's up against the wall, redneck mother. Mother who has raised the son like him.